Opt out or contact us anytime. President Trump, writing on Twitter, denounced the attack as a horrible and cowardly. The world cannot tolerate terrorism. We must defeat them militarily and discredit the extremist ideology that forms the basis of their existence, he said. In Sinai, the Egyptian military has been battling an Islamist militia called Ansar Bayt al-Muqdis, which pledged allegiance to the Islamic State in 2014 and has since proved to be one of the group's most effective local affiliates. The group's deadliest attack targeted a Russian jetliner that crashed shortly after takeoff from Sharm el-Sheikh in October 2015, killing all 224 people on board. Egyptian security forces have also been closely monitoring returning Islamic State fighters from Syria and Iraq, amid worries that an influx of battle-hardened jihadis could inject a volatile new element into Egypt's militant mix. Photo: the worshippers at the mosque were Sufi Muslims, who practice a mystical form of Islam that some Orthodox Muslims and Sunni extremists consider heretical. Credit European Press. Photo agency: the Egyptian authorities have been hoping to stem the tide of Islamist violence in Sinai through their sponsorship of a Palestinian peace initiative involving Hamas, the militant group that controls Gaza. Islamic State militants have previously used tunnels into Gaza to source weapons and get medical treatment for wounded fighters. One benefit for Egypt of the peace initiative, which Egypt's General Intelligence Directorate has mediated, is greater control over those tunnels. Until the spate of attacks on Christian churches this year, Egyptian militants had avoided large-scale assaults on Egyptian civilians, perhaps because history taught that they tended to backfire. After a massacre in Luxor that killed 62 people, mostly tourists, in 1997, President Hosni Mubarak launched a sweeping crackdown that crushed the Islamist insurgency centered in southern Egypt. Advertisement: continue reading the main story. When a new insurgency flared in the North Sinai after the military takeover in 2013, the extremists leading it were careful to focus their attacks on the uniformed security forces they blamed for the military takeover. But as those militants embraced the Islamic State, also known as ISIS or ISIL, they have gradually set aside that lesson. Many residents of Bir al-Abed, on the main road through northern Sinai, are Bedouins from the Abu Ghraib tribe, which is predominantly Sufi. Residents said that despite the recent threats by Islamic State, the town had been largely peaceful. The peace deal involving Hamas had further raised hopes that security was improving. But the Islamic State, a radical Sunni movement, has long considered Sufis apostates, along with Shiite Muslims, and has a history of attacking their mosques in other countries. Sufis can be Sunni or Shiite, but most are Sunni. The Islamic State in particular rejects the Sufi practice of praying at the tombs of saints, which it views as a form of idolatry. Since 2016, when the group released a video describing Sufism as a disease, it has claimed attacks that have killed at least 130 worshippers at Sufi shrines, most of them in Pakistan. Elsewhere, ISIS has made a spectacle of bulldozing Sufi shrines, describing their removal as a form of purifying the faith. In a statement, Hamas issued denounced the attack as a criminal explosion that violates all heavenly commandments and human values because it attacked a mosque. It is a grave challenge to Muslims worldwide, the group said. In October, Mr. Sisi ordered a major reshuffle of his security team after an ambush in the desert left at least 16 Egyptian security officials dead. That attack was later claimed by a previously unknown group called Ansar al-Islam, which is believed to have links to al-Qaeda. Follow Declan Walsh on Twitter, at Declan Walsh. Reporting was contributed by David D. Kirkpatrick from London, Rukmini Kalamuchi from New York, David M. Halpinger from Jerusalem.